everybody. In this video, you will find explanation of Act 2, Scene 6. The scene takes place before Shylock's house. Graciano and Salerino are present. They are waiting there for Lorenzo to help him to elope with Jessica. Now let's come to detailed explanation of the scene. Graciano: this is the penthouse under which Lorenzo desired us to make stand. Penthouse means a house with a projecting roof, forming an overhead shelter. This is the place where Lorenzo wanted us to stand. Salerino: his hour is almost past. It is almost past the appointed time. Graciano: and it is marvel he outdwells his hour, for lovers never return before the clock, and it is very surprising that he delays longer than the appointed time, because lovers are always before time. Salerino: oh, 10 times faster Venus pigeons fly to see love's born new maid than they are owned to keep obliged faith unforfeited. Venus is the classical goddess of love, who rode in a chariot drawn by doves. Doves, the pigeons, they are very quick to seal the promises made by new lovers. Then they are to keep the marriage promises broken. Lovers are always in a great hurry to keep a new engagement. Then they are to keep their marriage promises unbroken. Graciano: that ever holds. It is very true. Who riseth from a feast with that keen appetite that he sits down? Nobody rises from a feast with the same hunger with which he sits down to eat. Where is the horse that doth untread again his tedious measures with the unbated fire that he did pace them first? Where is the horse that can cover again the distance that he already covered with undiminished spirit? All things that are with much more spirit chased than enjoyed. Everything is more enjoyed in the course of their attainment than in the attainment itself. How like a yonker or a prodigal the scarfed bark puts from her native bay. How like a youth the ship decorated sails out from the native port, from its place, hugged and embraced by the wanton wind. How like a prodigal doth she return. And then on the way it is hugged and embraced by uncontrolled wind, and then she comes back like a spendthrift does. Spendthrift, the person who has spent all his money. With over-withered ribs and ragged sails, lean, rent and beggared by the wanton wind. With storm-beaten sides, tattered sails, torn, penniless, made by the uncontrolled wind. Salerino: here comes Lorenzo. More of this hereafter. Here is Lorenzo. We will talk more later. Enter Lorenzo. Lorenzo: sweet friends, your patience for my long road. Sweet friends, you for your patience for waiting for me for so long. Not I, but my affairs have made you wait. It's not me, but my business matters have made you wait. When you shall please to play the thieves for the wives, I will watch as long for you then. And when it is your time to go stealing a wife, I will wait for you as long then. That means when it will be their friend's turn to get a wife for themselves, he will also wait for them, as they are waiting for him now when he is there to steal a wife for himself, that is Jessica. Approach. Here dwells my father Jew. Ho, who is within? Come this way. Here lives my father-in-law Jew, the Shylock. Ho, who is within? Is anybody inside? He calls out if anybody is inside the house. Enter Jessica, a verb in boy's clothes. Jessica: who Who are you? Tell me for more certainty. Albert, I swear that I do know your tongue. Who are you? Tell me to be more certain. I can recognize your voice. Lo, love. Jessica, Lorenzo certain and my love indeed. For who love I so much? And now who knows but you, Lorenzo, whether I am yours? Lorenzo, and of course, my love, and who knows more than you that whether I am yours? Lorenzo, heaven and thy thoughts are witness that thou art. Heaven and your love and desires for me know that you are mine. Jessica, here catch this casket. It is worth the pains. Jessica throws a casket from top and says that it is worth the pain, the trouble that she has taken, because it contains ducats and jewelry, jewels that she had stolen from her father, Shylock. I am glad it's night. You do not look on me, for I am much ashamed of my exchange. I am happy that it is night and you cannot see me, because I am very ashamed of the change of clothes, as she is wearing a boy's dress. But love is blind and lovers cannot see the pretty follies that themselves commit. Love is blind and lovers, they cannot see the silly mistakes that they themselves commit. For if they could, Cupid himself would blush to see me thus transformed to a boy. If they could, then Cupid would have blushed to see myself in a boy's dress. Cupid is god of love. Lorenzo, descend, for you must be my torchbearer. Come down, because you will be my torchbearer. Jessica, what? Must I hold a candle to my shames? You want me to hold up a light to show my shameful dress? They in themselves, good sooth, are too light, because they are indeed of light behavior. Jessica is ashamed of wearing a boy's dress. That why it's an office of discovery, love, and I should be obscured. That would be an act of revealing me, my love, but I should be hidden because I am eloping with you. Lorenzo, so are you sweet even in the lovely garnish of a boy, but come at once, for the close night doth play the runaway and we are stayed for at Bassanio's feast. You look sweet even in that dress of a boy, but get down at once, because the night that hides our secret is slipping away, and we are awaited at Bassanio's party. Jessica, I will make fast the doors and gild myself with some more ducat and be with you straight. I will close the door, load myself with some more ducat and be with you. Exit above. Jessica exits from above. Graciano, now by my hood, a Gentile, and no Jew. So I swear that she is a gentle lady and she is not a Jew. Lorenzo, beshrew me, but I love her heartily. Curse me, but I love her with all my heart. For she is wise if I can judge of her, because she is wise if I can judge her correct. And fair she is if that mine eyes be true. And she is beautiful, if my eyes have told me the truth. And true she is, as she hath proved herself. And she is honest, as she has proved herself by keeping her promise. And Lorenzo is praising Jessica by saying that she is wise, beautiful, and honest. And therefore, like herself, fair, wise, and true, shall she be placed in my constant soul. And as she is fair, wise, and true, she in the same way, she will be always placed in my loyal heart. Enter Jessica below. Jessica enters. Now she is with them. What art thou come? Well, so you are come. On, gentlemen, away. So now, gentlemen, let us go away. Our masking mates by this time for us stay. Our friends are waiting for us. Exit with Jessica and Celerino. Enter Antonio. Antonio, who's there? Graciano, Senor Antonio. Antonio, fie, Graciano, where are all the rest? shame, Graciano. Where are the rest? It's 9 o'clock. Our friends all stay for you. No mask tonight. It's 9 o'clock and all the friends are waiting for you. There will be no mask party tonight. The wind is come about. Bassanio presently will go abroad. The wind has changed its direction and become favorable for sailing. And presently Bassanio will sail to Belmont. I have sent 20 out to seek for you. I have sent 20 men looking for you. Here Antonio is come with the news that there no mask party will be held that evening, and Bassanio is leaving for Belmont that very night. As Graciano will be accompanying Bassanio to Belmont, therefore they were waiting for Graciano. Graciano, I am glad on it. I am very pleased with it. I desire no more delight than to be under sail and gone tonight. I want no more pleasure than to be sailing and be gone from this place. So here Bassanio and Graciano will be sailing and going to Belmont so that Bassanio can take the choice of casket and marry Portia. With this, I end the explanation of Act 2, Scene 6. Thank you.